Hi, I'm John. This is my show, A Sports Reckoning. So, if you people don't know that the great curator's gentleman investor code, this thing that he has, this gentleman investor code, it disgusts me. He's no form of any kind of person to be bringing forth this gentleman investor code into the sports card community, because that's not who he is. He's a fraud. He's a scumbag, dirtball, like, kill him, take no fucking prisoners. That's the kind of person he is. He does not respect you. And what I'm saying about this guy, I'm going to show you right here. He says it in his own words. I don't have to, like, overemphasize what he does is what a fraud he is and stuff, because he proves it himself. And what it pisses me off is that the people in the community don't expose him for that. And the reason, then I yell at the whole community, because I understand that the whole community is a bunch of frauds, scumbag, dirtballs, just looking to take advantage of people. They don't respect the cards. They don't respect the players. They don't respect collectors and stuff. They don't respect people in general. So I say this whole community is fucking garbage and trash and shit. And so I use the great curator, because he's the one that's put forth this gentleman's investor code. And I'm showing you, if this guy, the guy that's bringing forth this gentleman investor code, if his true nature is a dirtball scumbag, then it's everybody's the same way. And nobody talks bad about him. And I know, because I know how people are. The reason you don't talk about him is because you want to be in his position, taking advantage of people. You don't fucking care about the cards. You don't care about the sports. You don't care about fucking collectors. Nothing. These are scumbag fucking losers and shit. So let's listen to what he says right here.
I'm right now.
We've got our small little trade cases. Yeah.
Okay, see right there real quick. He's like, Tinder, okay, how he did his hand sign and stuff right there. And so now I'm going to show you real quick what this exactly, like, what he did right there. Like, you people don't understand the subtleties of what he does. I can see the inside of who he actually is and shit, right? So let me show you. This is from the movie Trading Places and shit, right? So now this is what I'm saying. This is the difference. Okay, when you go into the, this is the World Trade Centers, you know, so you're dealing stocks and stuff. That's a dog-eat-dog world. Okay, when you're in that culture and in that environment, you got to be out there and be aggressive. And okay, that's what I'm saying. There's a difference. That attitude that exists in this kind of, like, market and stuff should not be the attitude that exists in the card market. It should not be the same. It's not the same, right? But what I'm saying is that the great curator shows the characteristics of these people in the stock market and on the trading floor, the characteristics of what exists there. He's bringing that kind of behavioral patterns to the card market. And I'm saying, that's bullshit. You can't be that way, and you sure as hell can't fucking put forth a gentleman's investor code and tell me I gotta be nice when you're the fucking piece of shit dirtbag out here who's got no respect for anybody. So let me show you, so you get an idea. This is the difference, and this is what I'm gonna show you with another piece with the curator too, to show you. This is what he really is, and this should not exist in the sports card community.
Never show any sign of weakness. Always go for the throat. Buy low, sell high. Fear, that's the other guy's problem. Nothing you have ever experienced can prepare you for the unbridled carnage you're about to witness. Super Bowl, a World Series, they don't know what pressure is. In this building, it's either kill or be killed. You make no friends in the pits and you take no prisoners. 1 minute, you're up half a million in soybeans, and the next, boom, your kids don't go to college and they've repossessed your Bentley. Are you with me?
Yeah, but we gotta kill them, motherfucker! We gotta kill them!
Okay, so that's the culture in that environment, okay? And what I'm clearly saying, I'm trying to make the distinction to you people, is this should not be the culture of the sports card community, right? That's not the culture of the sports card community. You should not have this kind of aggressive nature behavior if you're a sports card dealer. This should not exist whatsoever. The sports card community is supposed to be something different, but when I come into it, this is what I find. And then I find that the person out there that's promoting the fucking gentleman's investor code, that's who he is. Him. Right there. This guy. Right? Now listen to what he says. Listen what he said. I'm going to tell you what he says. He says, yeah, we got to go. We're going to go to trade night. And he says something like, I got to tenderize some fools. Some fools. I got to tenderize some fools. How in the hell does the great curator who's promoting this gentleman investor code, how does it ever come out of his mouth that he's got to say, I got to go because I got to tenderize some fools? Do you see how he thinks about you people? You're fools. He's going to take advantage of you because you're fools. And if he thinks you're fools, doesn't it benefit him as being the seller to promote this fucking gentleman's investor code so you're not aware of his real true nature? So he can fool you. So he can take advantage of you.
Ready, yeah. So I'm ready to go out there. I missed the last few nights because I wasn't feeling too well, but I'm feeling good and this is our last night.
So. And I will say this, guys, I'm back. I'm back, guys. I'm back in the game. I'm ready to do it. Let's go tenderize some fools, guys. We will see you guys next week.
Okay. Do I need to... Let's go tenderize some fools. I'm back. I'm going to kill him. It's kill or be killed. Let's go tenderize some fools. How in the hell could a guy that's promoting a gentleman's investor code ever say those words? And you could say, oh, he's joking. No, he's not joking. That's who he is. I keep trying to tell you, you can't joke about that. You can't be like joking. And so you could say, let's go tenderize some people. That's okay. That's a little bit joking. But when he adds in the fools, this is the thing, is that inside of them, they're the people that they really are. And I know that the way the human behavioral patterns actually work, and he can't fake it. You can't fake being a good person. You can't constantly cover up and be thinking inside your head that, oh, is this word, should I say this stuff? No, what actually happens is your true nature will always expose itself and it just comes out of you naturally. So when he's all excited, see right there, he's all excited, right? He's all juiced up, I'm back, right? Yeah, and then so his true nature gets exposed, and what does he call the people? Fools. That's what he thinks of you. That's what he thinks of you. So now, let me show you how he's fooling you too, how everybody's fooling you. You see that? This is a thumbnail. This is their current video, right? He puts a thumbnail of Kobe Bryant, right? He's like, oh, this is my tribute, my Kobe Bryant tribute and shit, right? This is my Kobe Bryant tribute. So, and he puts his thumbnail on the video. This is his current video. There it is, right? On his current video. Right? He's fooling you. He's trying to fool you and shit, right? But also, Kobe Bryant is trying to fool you too. And this is a thing where I ask people in the sports car community, it's like, look at, now, when you're a competitor and you're on the field of battle, like they were showing in the movie Trading Places, when you're doing battle on there, you've got to be aggressive. That's the nature of that environment, and I'm not against that. Same thing with on the field of battle. When you're in the field of battle on the sports, you know, you got to be like aggressive, kill or be killed. And I'm not against that, right? But children should not be thinking that way. We should not be training children until you get to like high school when things start to get serious. Before that, what you're trying to show is like companionship and humility, like, you know, and you're trying to teach children other characteristics of like playing in sports and stuff. You're trying to teach them that it's okay to lose. And then after it's over, we're still friends and shit, right? Sportsmanship. That's the word I was looking for. The sportsmanship thing, right? The sportsmanship is the thing that you're trying to teach children, because we know that most of those kids are not going to grow up and play pro sports. So we're trying to teach them good characteristics of sportsmanship and humility and, you know, show them human nature, you know, like to be a good person and stuff. That there's still that overrides your kill or be killed. Like when you're in there doing battle, go do battle. But don't forget that at the end of the day, we're still people and shit, right? You gotta treat people with respect and shit, right? So you're trying to teach children about sportsmanship before they get to high school, before they learn how to be a killer and shit, right? Because now it starts to get serious and shit, right? So this is what I'm saying about Kobe Bryant. Kobe Bryant, this video is clearly for children, 10 years old and under. Like, this is not even middle school children. This is elementary school children. Look at it. It's clearly with the hand puppet, the colors of what's going on here, the way the video's done. And this is being done by the professionals. These are people that understand in Hollywood movie magic and shit, that they know what they're doing. They understand how to hypnotize people and how to coerce people with the words and the imagery and stuff. They know how to do it. So Kobe Bryant made this video, right? And so This is the thing with, like, the great curator. Great curator, you clearly understand, you're a big Star Wars fan, so you understand about the Jedis using the good side of the Force and shit, and then the dark side of the Force, the other side, right? So you clearly understand. You wouldn't want to be teaching children about the dark side of the Force. And that's not the world in which we live in. Why would you ever want to teach children? But listen what Kobe Bryant does here. He's teaching kids how to use the dark side of the Force.
Every muse cage is powered by two forces. Light musings.
You're nice.
Oh, thank you.
You're great.
Oh, so nice of you.
And dark musings.
Worthless. You're a failure.
Make it stop.
Yeah, light musings make you feel good and happy. Dark musings make you feel bad and angry.
I don't like dark musings.
Most people don't. But what they don't understand is that dark musings just may be our greatest source of energy and power.
Oh.
If you're looking for your inner beast, it's most likely living inside of a dark muse.
Really? I don't know. I don't like feeling bad and angry, but I do need to find my inner beast. What should I do?
See, goes off like a hypnotist kind of thing. Do. I do need to find my inner beast. Kobe Bryant is teaching children about the dark side of the Force. I mean, there's no mistaking what he just did there. This is children, and he's telling them, if you want to find your inner beast, your greatest source of power, you got to go to the dark musing, to the dark side of the Force. Okay? Then this is the guy that, you know, great curator puts his thumbnail on there to, oh, I support Kobe Bryant, you know, and all this. It's like, okay, but it's like, yeah, I like I said, I don't have any problem with Kobe Bryant behaving that way on the court. I don't have any problem with him doing that. And I really don't have any problem with him teaching this kind of stuff to, like, high school kids when they start to get serious, being like, okay, now's the time that you guys got to get serious. You got to say, are you really going to commit to this, right? Are you going to commit to this sport? And are you going to really try? And if you do, this is where you need to maybe, and then I could say it's fine at that point. You could go ahead and teach them that, but not children. This has no place being taught to children. But who's doing it? Kobe Bryant's doing it to children under 10 years old. So it's like, yeah, I mean, so I kind of, Kobe Bryant seemed like a good guy and all, but when he does this, it's like, well, wait, you're stepping over the line here. This is out of bounds and shit, right? This is not good. And so when you people talk about supporting Kobe Bryant and stuff like the great curator, I'm going to put a Kobe Bryant thumbnail. Okay, do you understand that he was promoting the dark side of the Force to children? You know, but will the great curator ever make a response to this and give an explanation for this kind of video? Never. He would never say anything about it because he's wrong. There's nothing he can say about it. There is no explanation for him to give about what you just saw, what just happened there. Because they're frauds and shit. They're total fucking frauds. So now I'm going to show you. So here's a Drake. Okay, so there's Drake with Ken Golden, right? And so what I keep saying is, like, that I'm telling the sports card community, you do not have a fucking choice. You either fucking talk about Michael Jackson being the love child of Diana Ross and Smokey Robinson and how that can affect the card market of Michael Jackson collectibles, his collectible cards, plus all of his collectibles. And that's the community of which we're in here. And if you don't talk, all I say to people is, like, look, you need to tell people this information. And if you withhold this fucking information, then I'm going to expose you as the fraud. And I know that you're fake. And I know that you're a fraud. Fucking Neo Cards and Comics. Fucking Sports Card Dad. Fucking Great Curator. Fucking Merle World's Cards. Fucking AIH Sports. You too, motherfucker. You're a fraud. You're a fucking total loser. You don't fucking think that this is important. You think showing me your stupid little 1978 fucking Nolan Ryan card that you got is more important than fucking exposing to the world that fucking Michael Jackson's real parents are Diana Ross and Smokey Robinson, and that could have a tremendous effect on his collectibles and the community of which you're in? you stupid motherfucker. Because that AIH Sports motherfucker portrays himself like, yo, I care about people. I listen to people. I showed him a video of his number one fucking like idol of music, Chester Bennington, singing Michael Jackson songs. I show people with Michael Jackson hanging out with the biggest stars in the world that they're in his videos. I show them Michael Jackson fucking performing halftime shows. I show them Diana Ross performing the halftime shows at the Super Bowl. The whole Motown family with Smokey Robinson performing halftime show at the fucking Super Bowl. How much more do I need to show you? I show you Gary Vee. When Gary Vee's opening his V-Friends Zero Cool, he invokes the name Michael Jackson. He says, yeah, the Zero Cool product, when he's talking to Josh Luber, says this Zero Cool product can be like the Michael Jackson cards in the 80s. Everybody talking about Michael Jackson. Everybody understands that he's important, and he's important in this fucking community. But I got these piece of shit fucking community leaders in here, these influencers, who are all fake as fuck. They're stupid piece of shit losers who are looking to tenderize some fucking fools. I gotta tenderize them fools. I gotta get them. I gotta kill them. That's what they think about you. The only way that they could ever fucking act that way is because what I'm telling you, they don't care about you. They don't care about the fucking sports card community. They don't care about sports. They don't care about the players and shit. They don't care about the world. They are in it for themselves, and they say fuck you to all of you motherfuckers every time they refuse to talk about my fucking story. So here's Drake and shit with King Golden, right? Now, did or did not every single fucking sports card influencer that has a YouTube page, did they or did they not all talk about Drake and his opening of the flawless shakes that he was looking for the triple logo, man? Did everybody talk about that or not? They all talked about it. They all talked about it. Every single one of them. But who's talked about my story? Not one of them. Because they're fake as fuck, dude. They are fucking losers and shit, right? So here's a Drake song called Don't Matter to Me, which actually was a Michael Jackson song, right? So this is going to be Michael Jackson singing here, then I'll play it to where it comes to where Drake's singing and shit, right? But so it's like, just like a song, okay, Drake, there he is. Now let me show you Drake with Michael Jackson.
It don't matter to me.
Okay, just so you know, there's a Drake song. And so this is after Michael Jackson had died, he made this song and shit, right? But so Drake fucking made a song. This is actually a Michael Jackson song that don't matter to me. But he took that part and then he put his, you know, he put his own verse over it and stuff, okay? But he did a mix like that's like a dream thing. Do you think that Drake wouldn't have liked to have worked with Michael Jackson? I don't have to fucking ask, because there he is working with him. Even when Michael Jackson's dead, he's still fucking working with him. Still producing music based off the work of what Michael Jackson did. But you don't think it's fucking, you don't think Drake has a right to know the fucking true family lineage of who Michael Jackson actually was, that he's actually the child of Smokey Robinson and Diana Ross? You don't think that's important? Is Drake in the community or not? Is Drake in the sports car community or not? Did Drake just fucking make a song with Michael Jackson or not? And you people don't think that Michael Jackson belongs in this community? You don't understand the relevance of what the fuck it is I'm doing? You fucking losers, man. So now, this is Michael Jackson's memorial, okay? When he died, he had his funeral service thing, right? Now, one thing I want you to see here is, okay, now, so coming up on the stage here, this is going to be Kobe Bryant and Magic Johnson. Now, this is at the Staples Center, okay? This is that, if you people don't know, that's where the Lakers play basketball, the Staples Center, right? So it's one of these ironic things is, look at, here comes Kobe Bryant up here to speak about Michael Jackson at his, and so this is the thing I'm saying, okay, there's your Kobe Bryant stuff, you guys are all okay. Here's Kobe Bryant at Michael speaking at Michael Jackson's memorial, standing right next to a Magic Johnson and shit. But you people don't understand the importance of Michael Jackson to this community. And like I said, you don't care about the players. You don't care that they all care about Michael Jackson. You people are fake as fuck. But the ironic thing here is that here's Kobe Bryant coming to speak at a memorial taking place for Michael Jackson at the Staples Center. When Kobe Bryant dies, he has his memorial at the Staples Center. It's one of these ironic things of what has occurred is that when he's here speaking at this memorial, he has no idea that, you know, like 10 years later, that the people are going to be speaking at his memorial at that same spot and shit, right? That's life. This is how life fucking works.
Y'all know that nobody ever gave on stage like Michael Jackson.
We all know that nobody ever gave on stage like Michael Jackson. So, you don't think Michael Jackson is important to the sports car community? You don't think he's important to the sports players, to the music industry, everywhere? And you fucking idiots are refusing to talk about my story because you're like the great curator. You want to tenderize these fools. You want the people to be stupid and dumb. So you get some idiot, no talent, piece of shit loser like the great curator who could come out here and fucking feel superior over this community because he's taking advantage of you fools. He's feeding you crap. He's feeding you his fucking gentleman's investor code. And you motherfuckers ain't saying nothing about it. And you're going out there and you're fucking yelling at me like I'm the bad guy. Oh, I'm the negative. You got the whole community. We need to get rid of this negativity in the community. Yeah, we do. We need to get rid of this fucking negativity in the community, which is controlled by people like the great curator spouting their fucking bullshit propaganda, trying to fucking take advantage of you fools.